RTTV.
Gang.
If it's your first time here, definitely won't be your last. Make sure you kill, murder, and
smash
that subscribe button.
And make sure you head over to our Patreon right now, man. We got full and early reaction to shows like Bleach, One Piece, Boruto. We also got movies like Suicide Squad, The Conjuring, Space Jam with LeBron James, man. We got something for everybody. So make sure you head over to there right now. Sign up for the year and you'll get 16% off, man.
Yes, sir. Praise God, baby, because we have some RTTV merch exclusive on our Patreon, man. You see he got it. You see I got it. And exclusiveness all waiting for y'all. When you sign up, we're going to get it delivered right to your house. And every 3 months fall from that, you get another one, baby. All you have to do is sign up with the link right down below.
And make sure you give this video a like and have that notification bell ringing for that Kanye West playlist. And make sure you guys follow us on our second YouTube channel, RTTV Vlogs, where we have a bunch of original content such as skits, public challenges, vlogs, gaming, and much, much more. So make sure you follow and subscribe to RTTV Vlogs. Check out our Mexico vlog.
And we are back, finally.
Finally.
With the album that we've been waiting for. But all year, every week it's dropped, but it doesn't drop. And it's dope. Kanye West did something brand new. He premiered this album a whole different way. He went to live stadium shows and letting the audience, letting you guys A&R the album, saying what you guys like and what you guys don't like. And it looks like, you know, there's been a lot of back and forth going on in the hip hop game. The titans of rap all getting ready to drop their albums. And Kanye West is the one to set it off. Maybe without his permission, we don't really know yet.
Yeah.
But regardless of what, we happy the album's finally here. Kanye West put this. They said this is probably one of his most personal albums. It's dedicated to his mother who passed away. Mm-hmm. He has his brand also Donna that helps a lot of different communities and a lot of activism out there as well. So Kanye West has been doing a lot, and I think he has a lot of features on this album. It's 26 songs.
26 songs.
If I'm not mistaken. So I was like, what y'all expecting from this album?
Classic.
Greatness.
Timeless. Yeah, it's classic shit.
Kanye's gonna, he's back with another one. It's gonna be another classic Kanye album. He's coming for the Grammy. He's coming for the number one spot. He's coming for album of the year. It's Kanye season. It's Ye season.
Yo, man, as somebody, as you all know, that wasn't the biggest fan of Jesus is King, man. I'm just looking forward to seeing what he comes with this one.
You like, bro, y'all like, yeah, y'all said, yeah, it was a classic.
Yeah.
Jesus
King was way better than that shit, bro.
Show me footage.
Show me
footage.
Show me footage.
Pull up the clip. Pull up the clip. Pull up the clip. I didn't
say exactly what y'all
pull up that clip.
No, I'm telling you exactly.
Please, crazy. I liked it at the time. I didn't say it was classic.
No, exactly what you did right now. Clap. You said that one, yeah.
So before I listened to the album, I said it was a classic.
No, I'm saying
you said I'm just saying, you gonna take that seriously?
No, you guys argue with me. I actually did take it seriously. There's a whole footage of me arguing with y'all.
I know I did not say it was a classic.
Guys, it's going to be part of this. Y'all see it. I'll just bring it up. We got the footage. But we're going to get into this Donda. This is Kanye West's 10th album, if I'm not mistaken, 10th studio album.
And my boy is the Beethoven and the Mozart of this generation. Don't forget that, baby. The best orchestrator in history.
There will be great production. If nothing else, there will be excellent production. I always give Kanye that. He's a musical genius. Like, I didn't personally like Jesus is King, but, hey, he had some songs on it that I was like, yo,
but that was a gospel album.
This is some Jesus in your heart, bro. No, that's why.
I'm saying you can't compare the two albums because this is hip hop. Like the last one was just strictly gospel. So if you're not a gospel fan, it's like if he just did a rock album. If you don't like rock,
yeah.
But Ye, what you did like at that time, do you think it's gonna be better than Ye?
I hope so. I mean, put it this way: I've heard like snippets from like some of his like streaming parties or whatever, streaming shows, I should say, because there's a lot more people than the goddamn party. But yeah, man, I definitely expect it to be good, man. I hope it's good. I want to like it. So we're going to see. And I like gospel, so I don't want to say that, like, put it this way.
Oh, because you listen to Kirk Franklin. You love
gospel. You want to go back and forth? Gospel artists, I bet you I'll smoke
bro.
Your shit.
Silent night. Get out of here, bro.
Come on,
bro.
Man.
This kid's wildin'.
Boy don't know his gospel. Donda. Man says silent night. Come on.
We're about to get into the first track, Donda Chair.
Donda.
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 This is crazy.
Classic.
Who's doing this? It's crazy.
It's kind of scary, I'm not gonna lie.
I can hear you. I can tell it's like a, I don't know what you exactly call this, but it's like a, like it's a chant or something, right? Yeah.
I feel like I'm about to get a massage for some
like
reason.
Show like Donda, 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 Donda.
It's like when they say shame, shame, Donda, Donda.
Rest in peace, Donda.
About to get to track number two, Jill.
Oh, that was really the whole thing. Yeah. That's fire.
Jill.
Yeah, this is the one that. Oh, this is one of the ones I heard. Yeah.
This one with Jay-Z.
I believe this is a song that Marilyn Manson is a part of the, yeah, is a part of it. He said we are lions or liars?
We're all liars.
Liars.
Oh, okay. Like, it's hard for me to understand what he's saying.
Yeah, me too.
Like, with the, it looked like he was performing in the stadium recording this. Like, yeah. I was like, what is he saying?
His voice is extremely distorted. I can't, like, well said, I can't make up what he's saying, really. I like the prediction, the production so far.
The prediction.
The prediction
of God posting bail.
I'm just waiting for the beat to drop.
Yeah, it seems like he's saying, like, yo, we all saying we all liars, like, but I'm going to jail tonight for all my shit, but at the end of the day, God's going to post my bail. He's going to get me out of it. Mm-hmm. Where did Kanye?
Hove.
That's my celly?
Made in the image of God. That's a selfie. That's a selfie.
Hove.
Hey, I hope so, yeah. Hey. I like that verse right there. I can't even lie. That's such a big moment right there, bro.
It's just great to hear Jay-Z and Kanye West on a song again. That's just a moment, man.
Oh, is it the same song?
It is.
Ooh.
I never heard this song.
When you wasn't ready.
Thunder.
Now, he did this part when he was doing the bicep curls at the stadium.
Right? Oh, I was hoping there was going to be more to that.
Yeah, I thought he was going to rap
like, jail.
Maybe a chance.
Bail.
Kanye's done that on some tracks, though. He's done on Watch the Throne a couple times. Yeah, where he just switch up the beat and let it rock. But
Mozart.
I thought that was a dope track. I thought that was a dope way to introduce an album because we haven't heard a Kanye and Jay feature in a very, very long time. So to hear that, it's just like, it just reminds you how legendary the both of them are when they're together. And Jay-Z, he gave him a fire-ass verse.
Yeah, I did. It was very intimate. Mm-hmm. Real talk. I feel like it was very, like, I think, personal. Like, given the fact that I feel like this album was personal, I think he felt like he had to remain with that theme. And honestly, bro, even if we don't get a Watch the Throne Part 2, I feel like this was, like, a breath of fresh air to even, like, see them both together and stuff like that. And knowing that they're cool. Like, just knowing that, you guys are in a good place with each other, that makes me feel good right there, man. So, shout out to Hope for that one right there.
And it seemed like they might have not been in a good place a little while back. So, to hear him come on a song and kind of even check him, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And make a promise to his late mother, like, yo, I got your son, don't worry. You know, we might have not been on the right path before, but, like, I got him, and I'm going to make him stop all that red capping.
Red cap, yeah. I didn't hear that, too. Like, red cap, like the MAGA hat, right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Cool. And capping.
In general.
Yeah.
So it's about lying.
Yeah, I think this is like one of the first albums that they have like part twos. So it's dope. We got that first part, and I think the second part is going to have DaBaby and Marilyn Manson, the same song. So it's like, and some people said DaBaby snapped. He tried out with DJZ on it. I can't wait to hear that, man.
Facts.
Didn't he do that shit with Frank Ocean on St. Pablo? Didn't he have like a second version?
Yeah, because
he had like a Chris. Who's Chris
Frank's track? No, it was Frank's track, and the other one was
it was
Big
Wolves,
Mensa, right? Yeah, Wolves.
It was Wolves, but then he split it up. He just split it up, and then he just called it Frank's track, and then it was just two different songs at that point.
Frankie.
Track number three, God's Breath.
This one got a feature too.
I'm running away.
Like Jesus right here.
Yeah, yeah, right here.
It's like some Jesus drink.
Oh. You know how confident you got me to, like, I know God bless this song right here.
Oh, he switched it up. I thought the beat was coming back.
Yeah, right? This feels like I'm running fire.
That definitely sounds like a Jesus beat.
Yeah.
God the Father like Maury.
That That was the father like Maury.
Yo, God, God, everybody just watch Evan's reaction to this song.
Yo, God's the father like Maury, bro.
Yo. Hey, man. Oh, man. That was a bar, yo.
Boss of the year.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
That was bar of the year. I don't care.
That was definitely a bar, bro.
That was a dope ass bar. Legendary, right?
That was good.
What is better bar? I mean,
don't do that. Let's go to Family Ties right now.
Nah, you're right. You're right. My fault. My fault.
Y'all don't get it. This is God breathing right now.
No, you're not.
You didn't catch that shit went over your head, yo.
What?
It's classic. Timeless right here.
So God breathing sounds like an organ. Wrong,
yeah. I actually rock with this part.
Not me too. I just don't know if I believe his thesis.
What?
So if you're in the whip, do you let this song, like this part of the song keep going?
He made, this is you could easily tell he made this to perform.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Bro, he walked around for 3 hours and didn't say a word.
Yo, we about to get track number 4 off the grid. Featuring the man they said that carried this album.
Yes!
Fabio Foreign.
Bobby!
Stand up!
Viral!
Playboy Cardi.
Hell yeah.
Let's go.
I heard a sip of this one, yo.
Now I want to hear it. The way people been talking, I was like, I got to hear this. Bobby!
This song made Kanye get the bulletproof vest out. Go play.
What?
Green.
Crazy, boy.
I got to put my hat back for this right here. Cardi! Cardi!
That nigga really be mumble.
It's the one right here, though. It's the one so far.
Playboy!
Ooh, you hear that? You hear that drill?
Bobby!
Real Chris!
Bobby, turn up!
Nah, this song's a banger.
Hey.
This song's a banger. Why nigga still rapping?
What?
Nah, they say he carried the album.
Woo! You gotta move different when you're in the industry.
What?
Huh? Different when you're in the industry. Come on. Keep going.
Come on, Fabi.
Yo, he's still rapping.
Now, he had the best verse. I thought all three of them sounded
on the whole album.
Yeah, that's a fact.
I think they all three of them sounded good on the track, but that beat switch up was nutty, bro.
I don't know. Fabi kind of black on, like, he blacked on them, bro. I get why, but he blacked on them, bro.
He did black on them.
He
never said, hey, the ad-lib.
Yeah.
He did it.
And he didn't stop. He didn't pause between bars like he usually does. Like, he just kept going. The verse ain't even done yet.
He got another 2 minutes.
Kanye knew he was
snapping,
bro.
Kanye heard a rap and said, Fabi breathe on this one.
God didn't breathe on this. Fabi breathed on it.
Go stupid.
God breathing through Fabi.
God breathing through Fabi on this.
Yeah, see that? Nah, Kanye's fans are right here.
What are you talking about?
Yo, Kanye's on a drill beat.
Is he talking about Kim K right here?
Ooh.
I like that. I'm not delivering heavenly bars for the hell of it.
Oh my God! Kanye fucking wild!
Thanks!
Talk
to Kanye nice, sir. Fabi wasn't the only person that smacked on this.
Yo, because a black man will never share his rib.
That's a big bar.
Yo, first of all, Fabio, he blacked. He fucking blacked. But Kanye, he was like, all right, if you want to do that, then I need another verse too. I'm a black too. So don't sleep on Kanye on this song.
That's
one
of the best verses I heard from Kanye. Like, I haven't heard Kanye rap in a long ass time, nigga.
You could tell that verse, he definitely, like, I think definitely think Fabi wrote that verse.
Nah, yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised, bro. That's
Kanye was his first time on a drill beat. Yeah. Like, that was a drill, beat. And it's like, I ain't gonna lie, he bodied that drill beat. That was a really great. This spies, overall, I ain't gonna lie, I just don't understand Playboy Cardi
at all.
Nah, yeah.
That's some shit you gotta run back though. The way Cardi raps,
nigga,
like,
you cannot understand.
I was about to say, yeah. Run it back three times.
Understand Cardi?
No. I don't think that was the song. Like that was to me, that was probably the most rapping I heard. Like rapping, I don't know. Yeah. So far in the whole album, that was like because sure. Jay-Z's song was kind of like a poem. I don't know. It was like a poem.
I get what you're saying. Because even the beat was like
this was like y'all like I want to be top one. I'm number one rapper. Like let's like it was kind of like oh all right, Fabi, you did that. All right, let me. I just don't get Playboi Carti though.
Yeah. I didn't think he sounded bad. I thought he flowed well, but you could never really understand what Playboi Carti's saying.
Yeah.
He definitely got murked on this whole entire song.
He was like a bridge. Yeah. He was a bridge to go away to. Yeah.
Actually,
that's the reason why I think he should. I don't get why he on it because the song is mad long already. So like they act like you could have took him more than like 4 minutes. Still, like.
I like how you had a young rapper pull that out of Kanye though. Like I like how like Favi came on and that was the best I ever heard Favi for it. And Kanye came out. I feel like that was like how Sicko Mode when Drake dropped that verse, Travis was like, oh hell no, fuck that nigga. I gotta go rap again. And have y'all noticed that like he's blurting out the swears? Like he didn't tell him he can't swear, but like he'll be like, like it's like an edited version.
Exactly, yeah. I respect it though. Yeah, hey, yo, Favi, you stood on theme too. I feel like with him, he stayed very personal. He stayed very true to like his upbringing. He didn't. It was all about blasting niggas and stuff. It was like literally like how he like you know what he went through and stuff. So I respect Favi for that.
Like I'm happy that you gave Kanye your best verse. Like I think he knew he was like I'm gonna be on an album with Kanye West. I have no choice but to spaz. Like I have no choice but to go crazy. And like they even switch up the beat to cater to Favio Foreign too. So I like that too. That beat switch up was nutty. Crazy. That was a nutty beat switch up.
And if anything on these like on the latter part of Kanye's career, he does bring out some of the best verses in a lot of these younger rappers.
Made designer.
Chance the Rapper.
What?
No, Designer had that.
Panda already came out.
Yeah, you don't know you're talking.
Panda already came out before that, and it was going.
Bro, it came out, but was Panda ass hot though?
Yeah, they definitely gave it a push.
That push made it go crazy.
That's what he's saying though. He's saying that Kanye makes the best of them come out. Bob, Designer made
two different statements.
Yeah, that's not the same.
You got that? I stand corrected. I'm a man of my word.
All right, but we about to get into track number 5, Hurricane.
Louisiana, I'm praying for you.
Yeah, bro, I'm about to say that too.
Little baby in the weekend on here.
Oh yeah,
y'all. Oh, this the weekend track.
The weekend, the baby.
The weekend. This is a little baby. Go ahead. I feel this one right here.
Bro, the weekend's one of the best singers ever, bro.
This is meant to be performed.
That part's hot right there.
Bro, vocally, the weekend is one of the best of this generation, honestly. It could have been just the weekend the whole time. I would have been straight with that.
Yeah, I've never heard of that weekend.
So is that saying the baby didn't need to be on here?
The baby's on here?
I thought he did a sing, but the weekend. I've never heard a bad feature from the weekend. Like his vocal, to me, his vocals are unmatched.
No, I really think Lil Baby didn't have to be on here because, to be honest, I was so in the vocals of the weekend that I just. I can't even tell you a word that little.
Yo, time out. But she tried to run off with his heart, but he blocked the exits.
Come on, man.
Come on, bro. Like, don't steal my shit. I'm not gonna hold you.
It's funny because I thought I was the only person thinking that. I couldn't really understand what the little baby was. Yeah. What little baby was saying? I thought it was just me.
That's great.
I understood you. I understood you, little baby.
I understood that line, but. But I don't judge Reynolds.
It was all so simple.
Everybody's so judgmental. Yep. Everybody judgmental. Come on, man. I feel you. Yo.
That Father Hold Me Close, Don't Let Me Drown part is fire. Like, yeah. You could hear the orchestra in the background, too. It fits so well. That's why, like, I would love to see that in concert because, like, you could just imagine, like, the orchestra with the crowd. Father Hold Me Close, Don't Let Me Drown. Nah, the Weeknd killed that, though.
Yeah, I think like hearing Kanye's verse at the end made me realize what it was about Lil Baby. It just wasn't as much energy. Like, I feel like he wasn't like loud or something. Like, cause like when Kanye came in, I felt like Kanye's energy right there. Like he had a lot to get off his chest right there. So like, yeah. Kanye, yo, honestly, your verse is so far, man. I've been rocking with him heavy, man. No bully. I'll give you that, man. Real talk.
And I can see why people are saying it's one of his more personal albums because you hear him talking about his marriage with Kim.
Yep.
You know, the fact that a lot of people kind of judge
him for being crazy, although he calls himself a genius. You know what I'm saying? Like, so I feel you, Kanye. You've been through a lot, and I'm still gonna support you. I'm a real Kanye fan. I've been here since the beginning, nigga.
Yo, we asked Joe, you want to go to Sunday service? He was like, nah.
Yeah.
I was tired, man. I ain't gonna lie. I've been to plenty Kanye concerts, though.
We about to get into track number 6, Praise God, Baby Keem, and Travis Scott.
Baby Keem, nigga. Travis Scott. Baby Keem.
Track number 6. Praise God featuring Baby Keem and Travis Scott.
Yes, sir. Rookie of the year.
Rookie of the year for real.
Travis. Top 5. Yo, he's in my top.
Travis.
I love that flow.
Life.
Woo. I Kanye Styles, bro.
I serve.
Baby Keem. Still outside.
Yo, he really sounds like Kendrick, bro.
Yeah.
He sounds like Kendrick. It's the first one I couldn't pause.
Yo, my boy really got a whole 2 minutes at the end. Fabio Ford and Baby Keem got that treatment. It's Baby Keem season, you shitting me?
It's the put on, nigga. Kanye West is the ultimate alley-ooper.
What I will say is at the beginning of Baby Keem's verse, fire. Like, the only thing, the end and the squeaky voice at the end, I just wasn't feeling it.
Yeah, but
like,
that album and the chipmunk sounds good.
Everything else, he's bad.
I like the end part. That remind me of Kendrick. Kendrick be doing shit like that.
I don't like when he does that either.
That
should
remind me of
Playboy Cardi. Yeah, that's
more. I can understand Baby Keem.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I understand Playboy Cardi. Show Cardi, man.
But like the whole song overall is Travis Scott fire. Travis and Kanye body, especially that flow that Kanye did. Yeah. I was
That's
so crazy. I thought that was Travis.
It's a mixture.
They went back and forth that entire time.
Utopia.
It's lit.
Best album.
We about to get in track number 7, Jonah featuring Lil Durk and Voy.
Chicago, stand up.
Hell yeah. I could be the cleanest millionaire, but I'm from the mud still.
He died with his diamonds, man. They call that blood diamonds.
Yeah, ever since that Drake verse, man, Dirk been on fire.
Like, what?
You didn't even like that one.
I don't.
I like that song. I like y'all was saying, Vory's verse. And even Dirk's, I feel like y'all was saying, is vulnerable. I liked how he brought up the relationship between brothers, how it's important to, like, connect, because one day you're gonna, you know what I'm saying, one person might be gone. He's like, and he mentioned the relationship between Jay-Z and Kanye, you know what I'm saying?
I know he lost his brother this year.
RIP.
It sounded more like a spoken word to me than a rap. Like, it sounded like he was kind of speaking to the audience a little bit more than just like spitting, you know what I'm
saying? I hear you
saying, and letting it out like within the spoken word. So I kind of like that format that he used within this song. It was pretty dope.
Yeah, am I?
He's been letting a lot of the artists go first too, like all of them. Like, you go first, then you go first, and I'm gonna go last on all these songs. And that is usually you don't see that because the bigger artist goes first because they wanted to get that all that first attention, and it's good because it makes maybe if you didn't know Voy or you didn't know Lil Durk, you will listen to their verses even more to because you're waiting for Kanye's verse.
I guess you.
I feel like at a certain point. Like, when you're coming up, you want to be first because you want everybody to hear your shit. But once you're so established, like, if I know you want a track, like, if Drake's on a feature, put that nigga at number 7 minutes. I'm still going to listen to Drake's part. I have to hear that verse no matter what. So it is dope he does that.
Because there's a lot of superstar rappers right now that, like to go first. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Drake on letting Trippie Redd go first.
That was his song.
Stupid. Nah, when Drake was coming up, he needed that for, like, ain't he the first verse on Versace?
No, like, they needed to
come. I'm just saying.
No.
I feel like at that point, Drake was still getting the first verse.
No, but that's not. But as a artist, you would do it because at that time, no one knew the Migos. So anytime Drake went first, he actually was helping your track.
And Drake, I just think, body that bitch.
Yeah. So I feel like even the artist is like, I actually want him to go first. Like, wait, let that dude go first.
I know if it's my song, I'm like, yeah, you got that, bro. I'll be there eventually.
You'll hear me at some point in this shit. You'll let Drake go crazy.
I'll breathe.
Betrayal. But we about to get in track number 8. Okay, okay, featuring Fabio Foreign, Lil Yachty, and Ruga.
Let's go!
Yachty.
Oh! Little boat.
Nah, I Soulja Boy, like Lil Yachty, but I wanted Soulja Boy. That's all. That's
I take Lil Yachty over Soulja Boy.
Nah, not me. Not me at all.
But is the song he was supposed to be on?
Nah.
Oh.
I'm just saying Lil Yachty on here, so you couldn't get my boy Soulja.
He's supposed to be on what, like Remote something?
Yeah, with Young Thug.
I already like the sound of this.
It's eerie.
Yeah. See me if I look like a ghost.
What?
I love Fabio with the ad-libs.
Who does it sound like, nigga?
Travis.
You sound like Drake. That's Drake's flow.
I know. That's why I said it.
I thought you sounded like Travis.
I thought he sounded like Travis.
That's Drake, bro.
That was a Travis vlog.
That sounded like Travis, bro.
Yachty.
I actually like Lil Yachty on that shit, yo.
I didn't like Lil Yachty on it. In the beginning, I did. And then towards that, I was like,
yeah, it was like the midway in the verse. I was like,
I like this shit.
I'm like, I could do without Lil Yachty on this track.
Yo, my boy in the cage, he did more home runs than Babe Ruth.
It's funny because
I would have took another Kanye verse.
I would have took another, yeah, and it's funny because right before this, it's funny because right before this, I said the Soulja Boy remark about how I'd rather Lil Yachty than Soulja Boy, but like, like I don't know, like in the beginning I was like, okay, it's a little bit of bop. Then as it started going, I'm like, all right,
I like to
right, take him off the track.
That shit sounded fire. I'm not gonna lie.
She told me go to hell like I ain't been yet.
Damn, you know I'm kind of mad about though. This is one of those songs. I wanted Favi on this one right here. Yeah, I think Favi would have bodied. Like, yo, hearing him in the ad-libs, bro, that shit started fire. Especially, like, Kanye snapping you in. Bow! Like, that shit sounded crazy, but
Give Favi, take Lil Yachty's verse out and then give Favi the verse. That's what they should have did.
You know what?
Yachty hit is ridiculous.
It's crazy because it's a thing that pretty much Kanye West and him were going back and forth.
What?
But the verse that we heard Kanye, Fabi was rapping on, like, it was.
Oh, okay.
But I can't tell who was whoa.
Yeah.
What?
See, now I gotta run it back. I believe you. I'm just saying. I didn't really hear it either.
Kanye and Fabi were foreign, going back and forth.
Because in my head, I was thinking, what he just called me and said, yo, can you send me the
Yeah, it got to be the ad-libs, bro. Because there's no part in that I was like, oh, that's
you
Favi.
Right. I think that's what it is.
That had to be that, bro. There's no way.
Oh, he could have wrote it, too. Because I never heard it. Yeah, he could have wrote that.
The ad-libs could also be back and forth. Because literally, he would say something, and it would be like, bow! It'd be a Kanye line. That's literally back and forth, if you want to be technical.
Honestly, I'll take Kanye and Favi's ad-libs. The whole song, if I could have done that, yeah.
I need 504 to write a whole album for Kanye West.
It's like Kanye's doing his album.
Yeah.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
I bet. You know how like Travis did Yeezys and shit like that? I need like
that
504 to do something like that.
You said it's called The Bible?
His album's going to be called The Bible.
Oh, yes. I'm looking forward to that, yo.
We're about to get into track number 9, Junior, featuring Playboi Carti. Playboi Carti's on 3 songs.
Wow. Your boy really loves
He's dropping a new album, too.
Oh, yeah?
What does that mean?
Yeah, that beat go crazy.
I don't know if I'm rich enough to know what Junior wants to not be watches, yo. I don't know. I got enough money, yo.
He's a Japanese fashion designer.
Oh.
The protege to Comme des Garçons.
Oh, really?
Wait, what is it?
Oh, that's fire.
He's a Japanese fashion designer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Bro, I was over here trying to think, like, what is Junior Watanabe on my re? What you got on your re? Tell the devil good
night, go to sleep. He's an ad-libs. That reminds me of, you know how, like, Childish Gambino on, like, This Is America? He had, like, different people on the ad-libs. He had, like, 21 Savage.
Kanye
people.
West had Young Jeezy. Come on, Pat.
What? I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that he's a
Young Jeezy.
Yeah, like, I never said that Kanye never done it before.
No,
I was saying
that's a good more way of to the Kanye fans. Like Kanye did it 10 years ago and he's doing it again now.
It's only funny y'all say that because like I just seen some shit like niggas were saying that Childish Gambino say, yo, I love that I'm influential because like he had the white cover art before Kanye had just the straight black cover art and they try to make it a thing between them. So the fact that you brought up Childish Gambino, that's funny.
Something in my heart made me bring him up.
Not gonna hold you, Kanye, you my guy, but I could do without that song. I like the beat.
You doing a lot without a lot, bro.
That's
like,
not true.
It's crazy.
That's not true.
I said
two songs in one verse. Did you like Lil Yachty's verse?
No, I didn't like this song.
Exactly. Did you like this song?
I haven't heard you really express what you like. You just
I did express what I liked. What do you mean?
Like, so
I like the
like,
Travis
yo,
song.
I like the Travis song.
I like the Travis song, so you just ain't been paying attention.
Without a wow, without.
Listen, he's how you read it. Kanye wasn't paying attention.
Okay. Nah, he just wasn't paying attention.
That's
listen,
unfair what he's
listen,
doing listen. Right now. That's
yeah,
unfair.
No, that's unfair. Unfair. That's unfair because he hasn't been paying attention. He hasn't been paying attention to what I've been saying this album.
It's unfair. I like the Travis
song. I like the Baby Keem song. I like the Fabio song. I said two songs I didn't like and one verse. So what are you talking about? I said two songs and one verse. What is he talking about?
I appreciate him.
We had a lot of different reactions on this album.
Right? Right? Say something different.
Yo. You're about to get tracked number 10. Song, believe what I say.
So I'll say I can do without that.
You. I can do without you right now.
It's just Kanye.
Ooh, Lauryn Hill.
I should be on a cruise though, with this shit.
Yo. I could be on a cruise with this one.
Yo. I just feel like J-O will give an opinion on this, but he won't drop.
Huh?
You could do without this one, Jerry?
No. I actually like the sample. I was actually grooving in this one. There, yo, Wells wants me to like every single song on this album. He knows he didn't like those last two songs.
No, I didn't like the last one at all.
What is he talking about?
Yo, who else used this sample? Huh? Who else uses
Jizzy Drake Rogers?
What song is this?
He uses this for draft day.
Motherfucking roll on. I know Shorty and she done on the slow song. He's the same.
Everyone, Cardi B, everybody use that sample. This is so good. It just went to the next song, but this track. This is didn't it sound good to you?
Are you talking about that part?
It's track number 11, 24 featuring Voy.
Yeah, that shit was Junior Watanabe.
So far, I like that. That's one of the ones I'll cruise going to church with right there, yo. Reminds me of Jesus is King.
Yeah, it's smooth.
Fire. Mm-hmm.
It's smooth. It's a very soothing track.
Not finish. This is good gospel right here, Evan.
Yeah.
It's that gospel, man.
Yeah.
Like this.
You come at Pat. You couldn't come at me like that. I put you on your place.
Shit. When you come at me, yo.
How y'all feel about that one?
Like, I think that was a great gospel track.
I liked it.
I could hear it
gave me
Jesus
King vibes.
It was Junior Watanabe.
Huh?
Omari?
It was Junior Watanabe.
What does that mean?
Wow. I really like that song. That beat was good. The choir was good on it. I think that was good. But I honestly thought this album's gonna be more of this sound.
Me
but
too.
It really wasn't. Well, we got a whole.
It's a mixture.
We got a mixture of it. But this is like.
So maybe this is the part where it goes to that. So
this is the most gospel sounding track that we've heard on the album.
Even though all the lyrics has been infused with like praise to the Lord and everything like that, even with the features, everybody's like either praising the Lord or talk about the hindrances that they dealt with in their life that kind of like allowed them to be where they are right now.
Some type of like reference to their relationship
with God. Exactly.
It's like venting about their life and also atonement at the same time.
Mm. We're about to get into track number 12, Remote Control, with my boy Soulja Boy, was supposed to be on the GOAT. Don't have a disrespect. Go listen to his version. Stream that up too. We gonna get into Remote Control featuring Young Thug and Kanye.
Are you actually able to stream it? Like
on YouTube.
Oh, word.
You're my only fans.
Why are you so mad?
That whistle go crazy right there. That whistle's better than Lil Yachty's verse.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, I could do without this whistle, I ain't gonna lie.
I could do with the whistle.
I could do without the whistle.
I could do with the whistle.
Yeah, Young Thug started cool, but then after that, I need like a lyrics in the bottom of the screen.
Like, I didn't like the lyrics on the bottom of the screen. After I could definitely do without that Young Thug verse. I could definitely do without that Young Thug verse.
Honestly, I was joking when I said I could do without the whistles. The whistles are beautiful. And Young Thug, it looks like you influenced his whole song, even the Remote Control. It was probably you who told Kanye to do that in the studio. So if y'all like that verse, y'all like Young Thug. And Young Thug, although I couldn't understand you, it's early, you know what I'm saying? I'm still like jet lagged and shit, so it's hard.
Nah, I'm taking
Playboi Carti didn't get that same respect, and he was seven songs before this.
I'm taking Soulja Boy's verse over Young Thug's verse on this track. I could do a Soulja Boy's verse over Young Thug's verse.
It's the harmony in Young Thug's voice for me.
I like that computer love part, though. That's kind of cool.
Shout out Kanye, though. He sounded good on this shit.
He sounded amazing.
About to get in track number 13, Moon, featuring Don Toliver and Kid Cudi.
Don Toliver!
Cudi make every Kanye album.
That's Don Toliver right here? I think Robbie was right when he said we're starting to get the transition to like the gospel.
More gospel, more intimate.
Cudi, the most soothing voice of our generation.
That's not true.
Of our generation.
No, it's not true.
Yes,
it's
true.
The Weeknd.
This is what I know Cudi for right here, bro.
How can I get through? Next time I get a massage, I'm going to be like, yo, just put this shit on repeat. That's all I want to hear the whole time.
It's funny because I like Don Toliver's chorus, but I can't help but laugh. What he's like, like, I'm gonna listen to it and I'm gonna laugh, but I'm gonna be like, I rock with it, but it's mad funny. Like, I don't get it.
Yo, certified. They're going to track number 14, in Heaven and Hell.
He has the best voice of just praising the Lord and rapping. I love it, yo.
This definitely reminds me of Jesus King.
Yeah, real talk.
This definitely sounds like some songs that was on here. Like, and I like Kanye West's, like, he's really bodying it.
Yeah, because like with him, when I feel like when he speaks, you're forced to give him all the attention, and his words just, I don't know, hits every single time. Like,
when it comes to gospel music, yo, I'm sorry, Kanye West is killing it, bro.
He's that guy, bro.
About to get into track number 15, Donda. Let me just make sure it's not featured. Donda, and it's featuring Stallion the World and famous Tony Williams.
Yeah, I thought I said Stallion, like Meg Thee Stallion. Yeah,
Stanley Tookie Williams.
Of generations who came before
us. It's the kingdom.
Those are some beautiful words by his mom.
That's dope, yeah. That was dope.
I really appreciate hearing those words. I'm not gonna lie, that hit my heart right there, yo.
And the fact that he has that speech, you know what I'm saying, that ties in perfectly into this album, like that was dope. And that was a great honor to his mother, like a great tribute, I should say.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, R.I.P. Donda West, man. It reminded me of something like my uncle's been the choir director since I was a kid, and my mom been in the choir ever since I was young. So that reminded me of like going to their concerts and stuff like that. So I rocked with that joint.
I was in the choir 7 years.
I was trying to be the drummer and the conductor.
What did I teach him?
Glory. Take him to the church, yeah.
Yo, why Kanye ain't scared, baby?
You're right.
Take him to the church.
We about to get into track number 16. Keep My Spirit Alive, featuring Griselda, Evan.
Yeah.
Conway the Machine and West Gun.
West Side Gun?
Yeah, come on, bro.
Word.
Griselda, nigga.
It's Griselda Records, nigga. Real New York.
This reminds me of the old Kanye.
Yeah. College dropout. Graduation.
I've been liking a lot of the Kanye verses on this album right here, yo.
He got a couple, I tell you.
He said he about to build a Wakanda. Who's going to do it? Khan, bro.
He did something on this track that he did on Blame Game when he switched up like the tone of each line. Remember at the end of the second verse of
I get what you're saying. That he has like a dark and light voice.
Yeah,
type thing.
It'll get emotional. Some of it was chopped and screwed.
Yeah.
Some of it, like with this one, he kind of just did it with like the telephone effect. I don't know what exactly it's called. Then it's just regular voice, but he switched it up a couple times. I like that at the end. I like this verse too. You said it sounded like the old Kanye. I can hear this on one of his first three albums, either College Dropout, Late Registration, or Graduation. That's a vibes that I got from this verse.
Yeah. Real talk, man. It's amazing, brother. Sound like the old Kanye, my brother.
Yeah, he is on the College Dropout. I feel like Kanye's always been the type to kind of mix rappers all in one place that really would never have rapped together in the first place. Mm. I guess he's doing it with the album because I would never hear like Griselda and then I would hear like a Little Baby or something like that on the same album, you know what I'm saying? So like, that's pretty cool.
Feel you.
We about to get into the next track, Jesus, number 17, Jesus Lord, featuring Joel's main man himself. Ooh. The sharpshooter, the best verse. The album of last year, your boy, none other than the boy J Electronica. Oh, let's go.
That's my boy.
J Electronica. I really had no idea who he was about to name, yo.
Me either. Father didn't show
up. As he just feeling lost, like he's really telling a story.
Yeah, hell yeah. I'm like, that's it deep.
Wow. Wow.
That was the closest to me crying throughout this whole album. I ain't even gonna lie, yo. That, cause it's like he started off with like his pains and how like a lot of moments that he has to deal with addiction and drugs and stuff, and then transitioned to like a story where somebody else had to deal with drugs as a coping mechanism, like the mother, the brother having a revenge plot. Like this was very, yo, Kanye, man, he really getting like right here with it.
This was the snippet I heard when I was like, yo, this album is crazy. I kind of wish this was the first song though. Like, I wish he started the album instead of the Jay-Z song. I wish he started it like this. But the thing, too, I like about it is because I ain't gonna front to you, man. Kanye snap, but yo, my boy Jay Electronica, bro. Now, the thing is, I didn't know it was him. That's why when I realized, because I heard this is probably the only song I heard some of. And
wait, which part was him?
No, he's about to.
He's not.
Oh, okay. I'm like, wait, what?
Else, I thought it was somebody else when I heard it.
Oh, okay.
So I
okay.
didn't know that was actually him. Actually. Mm. That's why I liked it a lot. But let's get into it, man. J Electronica, do your thing, player.
Jesus! Real shit, nobody else needed to be on that song besides J Electronica.
Yeah, it was perfect. It was perfect.
That's my favorite song on the album, and I'm not gonna like, that's like a it doesn't give me the same energy of this song, but it's like a perfect match in heaven. Like it's like this song's gonna be completely different. Don't get confused. But like Renegade, how Jay-Z and Eminem just rap both very well. It's a whole different type of song, but like I think they both like it was no one else that could have made this song as perfect as them two.
Yeah, you're talking about the caliber. I get what you're saying.
Yeah, like I feel like they both matched it in different ways. Like Kanye rapped his best, but in his way.
Yeah.
And J Electronica rapped it his best in his way, and it just blended so well. Like it was like Kanye West was like more easier to it was just like everyone understands Kanye, and then J Electronica is like, yo, I'm gonna give you not like a knowledge in it. Like
yeah, it was a lot of knowledge.
So much stuff in it, and it was just like. Honestly, that's the best. That's my favorite J Electronica verse ever.
It was like Kanye was a storyteller, just telling you about like life situations that are more personal to people within the hood. And then J Electronica is just giving you history of some of the things that have been done to these third world black countries. Some of the things that have just been done in the world, like how we black men were kings and. All in all, like I like J Electronica's verse, and I always like his verses because he has a different type of flow that isn't like anybody else's. It's like a spoken word, but it fits you so well. I can't even really describe it aside anything from that. And nobody else, I can't hear anybody else in the game doing that and it sounding good. J Electronica's the only person that could really do that and it sound good. Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like on this joint right here, one, if you watch RTTV, that's probably the most quiet we've ever been through a whole entire song. Like, I honestly think that if you've ever watched this, that's probably the most quiet we've ever been. Like, we were really locked in for this one, and I feel like Kanye gave definitely more relatable things, but like J Electronica, I love that. Yeah, you got to pull out your Googles, bro. Like, to understand a J Electronica verse, you really got to pull it out and kind of go through it. Like, he's going to say something that you're like, what exactly did he just say? You got to pull it back.
And I think that's why I like this so much, because like, I ain't gonna lie, I really understood a lot of stuff he was saying. Like, a lot of things he was saying, I'm like, boom, boom. Like, he just took it, like Jerry said, he took it to the third world countries. Then he took it to biblical terms with Solomon Gomorrah. And it was just a lot of different things he was bringing up, like genocide from different, like, it was just all history. Like, that's what it is. I'm a history buff, and that was a history buff verse. Like, literally, every line was knowledge. So, yo, look the lyrics of that if you want to learn something. Shout out to J Electronica.
Yeah. I feel like Kanye really talked about like what people went through kind of like in the last like 50 years, something like that. You know what I'm saying? Like what they did to the people that look like us with the drugs, and how people, because they saw their parents kind of go through that, that's how they chose to cope with it. You know what I'm saying? My mom was on drugs. I love my mom. So if I'm going through something, that's what I'm going to go through, because that's what reminds me of love. You know what I'm saying? And then J Electronica kind of just broke it down, like, as a people, they did this to us historically. And then, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was kind of dope to see that. And you guys are right. This is like a perfect collaboration, and one I didn't think I was going to see.
This song is Donda. I feel like this song encapsulates the whole theme.
That's why I wish it was the first song. I would, like, not saying the first song ain't good, but I just would, like, this is track number 17. So you see what I'm saying? Like, I just feel like you would understand Donda more if this was dope. Like, you'd That's get the premise. But overall, it's honest, so I ain't tripping. Track number 18, New Again, written by Chris Brown. Every Thursday, posting me in Malibu, you posting
pics in Jersey. It's the lane. Chris Brown wrote this.
Yo, I'm going to give...
If I hit you with a...
If I hit you with a WID, you better hit me with a hi, yo. I'm going to hit him with the Jerry, yo. I could do without this, yo.
Hey, man. What else can you do with this song?
I feel like there's a lot of songs.
Yo, he asked Michelle's approval. He said, yo, Wells, could you
do,
this
song, Wells? Could
nah,
you do this song?
I was going to say my honest opinion. I feel like sometimes Kanye likes to sing rather than letting somebody else do it. And sometimes I prefer somebody else to just do it.
Chris Brown wasn't pulling that one off either.
Hi, what a bunch of eyes. He was definitely trying to sing.
I've heard Kanye do stuff like that, though. Without it being written by Chris Brown, I don't think that was singing. That was just trash.
Wow. Yeah, we're going to get in track number 19, Television featuring Pop Smoke.
Yeah.
R.I.P. Pop.
Yeah, this might be like a different version of the song that he has on Pop Smoke's album.
Nigga,
you know, tripping, wilding on television.
Nah, but Kanye's not on this song, though.
No, okay.
Nah, niggas gonna have to leave Pop's vocals alone, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I do not think Pop would have wanted this one right here. Like, I don't know.
This is the same.
This is
literally the same song from Pop Smoke's album. He just tweaked it a little bit. It's the same beat and everything.
It's still put on at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? He's on Donda, bro.
And
you know what I'm saying? And he's passed away. A lot of people, Pop Smoke. I feel like for people that didn't know Pop Smoke, they might want to go listen to his discography after this.
Pop Smoke for the past 2 years has been the hot, like, streaming wise. Like, everyone knows.
He didn't need this.
Like, Pop is big. Like, music, he had the most streamed album the last year. So it was like,
it ain't like he took it without their permission. They obviously wanted him.
Nah,
you know what I'm saying?
So like, I'm
just saying, like, I think if it was approved by his team, you know what I'm saying? I think it was a smart decision.
I just don't see why he put this on it. That's more of, I feel like it was more of a streaming thing. Like, let me get my numbers.
I just don't understand. It doesn't like you had 27 joints.
I feel like Instagram right now, like, nah, he tweaking. That's how I feel with Kanye.
I think he should have just kept that version, because I feel like what he tried to do with this is what he did with a Designer with Panda, and try to do the same thing.
He was on it though. Like, Kanye is not even on the song
at all. No.
Like, that's the whole song.
Because Kanye was on the version on the Pop Smoke album. He was on that version. I think that's why they called it. He even called the song Television, because he says tripping, wilding on television. Granted, I don't know why he wouldn't just have a verse on this, but
sorry, P Pop, man. Can't never say Pop and forget the smoke.
Facts. Yes. Track number 20, Lord I Need You featuring Sunday Service.
That choir fits so perfect right there. And Weezy out of here.
I like that joint.
Me too,
that joint. Another real personal joint for Kanye right there.
Nice and retrospective, you know, talking about his relationship right there, you feel me? And I think, like, with him, considering the fact that his relationship is really in the limelight and stuff like that, it's, like, it's cool for him to really give his perspective on, like, what's going on and everything like that.
Yeah, and the fact that, like, throughout this whole release, he's kind of been quiet. You know what I'm saying? There's the divorce going on. He hasn't really spoke about it too much. You know what I'm saying? Like, she's still at the shows with the kids. It looks like the relationship is still there, but then it's not. And then the fact that he comes out, makes his track, it looks like the love is still there. He's just Kanye, you know what I'm saying? And they're gonna argue about that. So
it makes me think, is this the song that she came out in the wedding dress to at the streaming joint? Like, I don't know what song it was, but I would think if any song we've heard so far,
it's
would
definitely
be
this one.
100%.
Yeah, man. I wish this was in the front of the album. Let's get into track number 21, Pure Souls, featuring Roddy Ricch and Shanice. I'm the one that was chose. All of my friends love the gangbang. Now we in my car, you say we ain't in the same lane.
When we both came to the phone, we standing for the prom before Chief Keepers. Before Chief Keepers, bang, bang.
Yo, I really enjoyed Roddy on that right there. I feel like his voice, his flow, his cadence, everything was really perfectly married to this song right here. Like, I appreciate Kanye knowing exactly like Roddy was able to be placed right there in that song right there.
This album is really long.
No, I knew. I felt like at the beginning that was going to be my biggest criticism, and I just know that's going to be it now. Yeah. Like, I know, like, if you made this album really concise, there's joints in there that would have been, there's joints in there that I think, like, put it this way.
He should have just made it deluxe, bro. He should have, if he just gave us the 12 and then gave it deluxe, it would have gave us more time to digest it.
Yeah, I think, like, one of my favorite things about this album is going to be me going back and being like, all right, I could have put this here, this here, this here, this here, this here, and it would have been the album. Like, that's what, you know what I'm saying? Trying to figure out how I think, yo, if you would have track listed it out like this.
Like, I ain't gonna lie, the last part of this album has been more like really fire to me. Like, Jesus is Lord, Pure Souls, Lord, I Need You. Like, those three songs are like the top.
Nah, I think if you would have chose 12 of all the best songs on this, this album would have been crazy.
Yeah,
like,
crazy.
Yeah. There's just too much going on. Just a lot.
Bro, we still have a lot to go.
Rob and Sonic is like 20 songs left, yeah. So he be singing sometimes. That should be probably sound fire, though.
He be singing, bro.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, you know
where to find me. Like, I just sometimes when he gets in that pocket, I really enjoy his vocals. Yeah, I can't front, though. I like that right there.
This is the most interesting Kanye reaction we have ever done for me, yo.
Yo, I feel like he has so many songs that he did this singing joint that he could have just picked like two of them. You know what I mean? Like, you know what I'm saying? I mean, me.
Could you elaborate on that? Why is it the most interesting?
Rush is so far, I'm just not like really rocking with it.
Nah,
like.
I know he's not. The only thing I can say is he said he didn't drop it. So that's the only thing I can give him. Is like, that's not how I was going to drop it.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Bro, 27 like, joints? Like,
bro. But it's like, the thing is, the after these next two songs is the same song but just with new verses.
Yeah, exactly.
So my whole thing is maybe you should just made it longer. I don't know. But let's get into it.
He should have dropped a deluxe on Certified Lover Boy. Yo,
imagine he drops a deluxe still.
I'm about to say he got another 30 pack for Drake's release day. What you talking about? Got another 30 pack.
Yo, I don't know about you. I don't know, Evan.
Yo,
we about to get a track 23, No Child Left Behind, featuring Sunday Service Choir.
No track left behind either, nigga. Drop all that shit.
No track left
no
behind.
No track.
You recorded 27. Everything.
That's why Soulja Boy is heated. You dropped. I
could have got part two, nigga.
And Chris Brown, nigga.
Like, let me get a part three or something, nigga.
That's
shit George Bush used to say. No child left behind. I think he made it a thing.
Isn't it something in like public schools or something like
that?
Yeah. I think it's a little more to it. But essentially.
I think one child fails, everyone fails, some shit like that. I don't know.
Like, I passed a lot. I see a lot of people fail. I went forward.
But like at the public school, I think it was. Like
I was about to be like, yo, you try to hold my nigga back, you can't leave him behind. Get him back in here.
I'll say the opposite. I'm like, because he failed, I can't go to next grade.
Wow, you that nigga.
Oh, yeah, I studied.
I wasn't trying to bring you with me. I was just trying to go.
I ain't going to no summer school.
And now it's time to get into the part twos. Jail Part 2 featuring the baby. What he was?
Yes, sir.
$1 million baby.
Let's go right to this verse.
Live show killer.
This is going to jail tonight.
I rock with that verse right there, the heavy, bro. Real talk.
Why should just put Jay-Z and thing on the
same song?
I'm just mad.
Track. Why not,
bro?
Well, because he got it late. Remember, that was like one of the controversies yesterday.
The album. Yeah, initially wasn't on Spotify.
Because he didn't have that song on there because he said he had to get it cleared through the manager. Yeah. The manager, he said the nigga didn't answer.
They weren't approving our song.
Yeah, yeah, so I think that's why he ended up doing the part two on it.
The manager responded like, yo, bro, what you talking about?
I never got your text, man.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, maybe because Jay-Z was on it. Maybe like Jay-Z was like, nah, nigga.
I'm the real billionaire, baby.
He's like, yo, if I'm like your album first, the door's going to be on the song and it got to be first.
Yeah. Say, be part two where, nigga?
And I'll say, watch the Tone might return. I might just say it.
I might just say it.
Well, we about to get an OK OK part two. I don't know. Where Shardy saw it, though.
Sean Sayer,
it almost looks like Sean C. That's how you spell it. S H A N S C E A.
Yeah,
Sean C. Who's that, Lil Durk?
Nah, that's real good. He's on there. Oh, okay. Yo, so I've actually heated listening to this because it's like, why didn't you just have this as an original version to begin with? We don't even need a part two. Just take Lil Yachty off that whole track.
At least we got Lil Soulja
Boy off. Yo, wait till Lil Yachty catch you in round two. Wait till he can catch you in round two, nigga. You live in LA.
Let me get a picture. I could do without it.
Track 26. Track number 26, Junior, Ty Dolla Sign's added.
Junior Watanabe. Yeah.
Woo, 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 woo. Yo, I didn't even like part one, so the fact that I don't like part two is like, I guess I just like
it. Yeah, that's yet another verse I could do with that Ty Dolla Sign verse was not good. I did not like that at all, bro. Like, why did he sound like that? Like, come get him and get Ty. That's why I'm even more mad because I actually like when they do tracks together, but that was not good.
That was like, yo,
that was like, I don't know what that was. Like,
that shit was ass. That was the worst verse on his whole shit.
Nah, that was
bro.
The worst song on the album.
Yeah.
I just like saying Junior Watanabe. Yeah. It's almost like a troll of the song. You know what I'm saying? Junior Watanabe with my wrist.
It's not like I trolled the song.
The crazy part is, you never got that ST. On my wrist.
Yeah.
You never got the wrist. I don't even. Wrist.
You can't, bro.
And the last track, fresh off of Versus the Locks, Jesus is Lord Part 2.
Hey.
Oh, all right, cool.
With the ghost.
I fuck with that right there.
Jesus. Love. I'm going to keep it a buck. You can keep Jada and Styles P. I didn't like Sheik Lucha's verse.
Sheik
Lucha
Styles P.
No, I didn't like.
You're saying he can keep them. Like you saying like.
I hated Sheik Lucha's verse. It was just like Sheik Lucha's verse just didn't make sense to me because it just sounded bad. Hood, like, yeah, it sounded choppy.
He swore the most,
and he was swearing the most.
The ghost swore the most.
Yeah,
like Styles P. Yeah.
Jadakiss bodied that.
It should have been Kanye, Jay
Electronica, and Jadakiss.
I feel like Jadakiss brought the hood perspective of all three stories. Like Kanye, you said like 50 years of just the common person, and then Jay Electronica had the historical, and then Jadakiss just had the streets. Like, yo, street niggas need God too. We need Jesus, but this is the way we need it in our terms, what relates to us. And I love that they gave that perspective. I just wish that even if they were gonna put the locks, put Jadakiss after Jay Electronica, because Sheik Lucha was just too much spacing.
Space. Honestly, this nigga, I feel like Kanye's seen a Versus battle. You're like, you know what? You deserve verse on this album.
Yeah. That's definitely what it was. Like, shout out to Versus, yo, because you know for a fact, I think they felt like we all felt when we watched that battle, like, wow, the locks.
I ain't feel that way.
I would have been. Nah,
I like Dipset, right, man?
I like it too, just not in that Versus.
If I saw that Versus battle, I still would have gave the whole verse of the whole locks. I still would have just been like Jadakiss. Nah, like, I'm just giving it to Jadakiss. If I'm basing it off the Versus, Juice be tough.
I've done that before. I don't like it. He knew. He just put Jada.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
So I like Kanye and Jadakiss collabs. Kanye really brings a good side of Jadakiss out, too.
Yeah, I definitely appreciate him on this right here. Yo, Jada. God damn, bro. I don't know how old you are, but you just keep pumping out these verses, my guy.
Yeah, this album overall, that was the last track. Great.
Jesus, Lord.
Great tribute album, I'll say. I think it was a great tribute album. That's how I'm looking at it. I'm not looking at it as a Kanye West. Like, I think this was just a tribute album. It was just getting those emotions out and getting what his mother taught him and the knowledge out and just shown that everything she taught is gonna always live on, and I think he, him being religious and him having that is definitely from his family. And I think Kanye West, this was very personal. I think we got to see a lot and understand a lot more in Kanye West's mind, even his relationships, even what how he feels about losing his mother and overall. And I think the features were dope. Jay-Z did his thing. DaBaby did his thing. Who else?
Baby Keem.
I almost forgot.
Travis Scott.
Travis Scott.
Jay Electronica, of course.
Yeah, some of the features were really, really good. Some of them were completely unnecessary. There was, I honestly, as a Kanye fan, I will say that, like, yo, the album's cool, but there was just way too many tracks. Like, I really think that, like, if we condensed this album down, then it would be way better than it should be. But yeah, like, aside from that, I think that some of the ending tracks were kind of unnecessary. Like, the part twos were kind of necessary, some of them. I think some of them were needed. I think some of those part twos actually should have been the original song. Actually, only one of them should have actually been the original song, yo, that original verse.
But I'm just saying, that's
how I feel. If you don't like it, then whatever.
They catch me around too.
Yes, we have
whatever.
I'm happy because I know I got at least like 8 songs out of this that I'm gonna have on repeat on the flow of my playlist right here. Like with Kanye, I feel like with him, he was in the studio in his groove within the Mercedes Stadium, and it's hard for him to like remove certain songs. I feel like he had a connection with a lot of different verses and stuff like that, and he felt like, other than Soulja Boy and Chris Brown, that those people needed to be on his project one way or another. So like, Kanye, honestly, yo, shout out to you, man. Like, you blessed us and stuff, yo. So I'm gonna enjoy a lot of the tracks that you gave into. I feel like there's gonna be songs I'm gonna go back into and have a better connection with, because like, you know, some songs is like you gotta sit there and soak into the lyrics and stuff like that. So shout out to Kanye on this, right, man.
Yeah, Kanye, you once again changed the game with this album. I feel like the rollout for this album is just, I think, could show a lot to new artists that's trying to get hot again. You know what I'm saying? Like, not everybody could do what you did. Like, you always change the game when it comes to that. The rollout for My Beautiful Dark Twisted the Fantasy, you know what I'm saying? Rollout with Graduation, going head to head with 50 Cent. There's always something special to like a Kanye West album. And these live streaming events, that was special in hip hop, because especially now, like, this hip hop is so dead. Like, where's Nas, yo? Like, real shit.
He just dropped.
He said hip hop is dead. Remember, he dropped the album. I asked you to listen to that Nas album.
It is actually a good album.
Yeah, I thought it was good.
Did he win a Grammy?
He did win a Grammy.
Yeah, he won a Grammy. Shout out to Nas.
Yo, shout out to Kanye, man. This album. If anything, I think it was a really great genius rollout, man. Ain't nobody making millions of dollars before the album drop off the rollout.
Let's correct that.
Who's making millions of dollars off the rollout?
Let's correct that. Kanye West is a billionaire. To do what he did, he's spending $20 million. He made $10 million, so he is actually losing money doing that. That's why no one could actually do that.
He's writing that shit off too.
And he's. That's what he's doing. Yeah. But he's a that's a billionaire salary.
Not
like,
for sure.
What he did is billionaire. Like, you can't just go to Mercedes Stadium and say, I want to rent it out and charge 20. Yeah, he's charged only $20 a ticket.
I never seen somebody stand where Kanye stood at that stadium to watch the game. I ain't never even seen that shit. Like, he was at the top of the shit looking over it. Like, I was like, hey, man.
So every fan out there, give Kanye West credit, because he didn't do it to make money at all. He just did it to give you guys an actual, like, you think to build his home. His actual home and put it in the stadium, that costs a lot of money. So he just did it for the art.
Yeah, he's a person. He's a person that I respect for always wanting to get his ideas out
Jay-Z
the way he wants to get
them
out.
Never do that for you.
Nah, I don't know if Jay would do that, but I definitely.
Jay-Z ain't do that for Dottie Optic.
I can't wait to go back to this album, because I'm not gonna lie. On first listen, I don't know how much replay value it has for me. A lot of the joints.
You know what happened?
But there are some joints that I fuck with.
I feel like for a Kanye album, this is the first one that I feel like the production was very similar to a lot of the tracks on it. So I feel like once we got to the middle of the album, because it's 26 tracks.
Yeah, I already heard it.
Yeah, I feel like I already, it's starting to just blend all together. You know what I'm saying?
Maybe you heard the same song twice too.
Yeah, exactly. That too. You know what I'm saying? That too.
Like, the beginning, I'll say like the beginning of the album, the production was a little bit more diverse. It was a little bit more different.
And
like,
we had more features.
Yeah, and we had more features. And like the beginning of the album, like for me, the beginning of the album.
Honestly,
I thought he had features all the way through.
The last of it had
Jay
the last of it, but like
in
the middle,
But they was like, I like the beginning of the album more towards the end of the album, though. I'll say that.
You like the beginning of the album? Oh.
Yeah, I mean, I can make a. This is an album that you just make a playlist, kind of exactly. Down the playlist.
Yeah.
I have a good 8-9 songs on here, but. Certified.
No track left behind. Kanye West.
Family Ties.
44-45.
Wow, he did that.
Shout out to everybody that's in here. Shout out to Kanye signing off the summer, man. Mm-hmm. Everybody that's rocking with us, make sure you tune in this Friday. You already know Certified Lover Boy is about to drop. Classic already. I'm calling a classic on another person's review. So make sure you stay tuned for that. And
that's
trust me, this Friday? This Friday.
Yeah, Friday. Oh my God.
And then after that, maybe Kendrick come the next week. Yo, you know, I'm just hoping that back-to-back releases from all these heavyweights, we appreciate the competition.
Yeah.
Competition is good because only beats more music. I feel like Kanye West has everyone excited again. And with COVID and everything stopping, it's good to have that excitement back. So shout out to all artists. Shout out to Drake, Kanye West. Keep it all music, man. All fun. And yo, let the debates begin. And then the season just started, man. Hip hop, we back.
Facts.
It's your first time here. I promise you definitely won't be your last. So make sure you kill, murder, and
smash
that subscribe button. I go by the name Rob City RT, the Haitian Prince. And this is our first reaction in the music room. We're going to have some stuff up soon, decorated. And we're going to have some new styles of reaction videos coming real, real soon. We can't wait for you guys to see it in here. But thank you guys for helping us get this far, man. And I am that hip-hop guy, that rock guy, that pop guy.
Yo, that's the music guy.
Check out all our musical reactions. Check out our Kanye West playlist. Link in the description below.
Yo, Patrick RT, ain't no rapper going to be praising the Lord like Kanye West. Who's making an album all about the Lord Jesus Christ? Jesus! Lord!
Rapper. Yo, we could have been the choir right there. We killed that shit.
Yo, it's your boy Wells, the anime king. Kanye West, I just want to say I love you, man, forever. I really enjoyed this album somewhat. And it's really just the first listen. You know what I'm saying? It's 26 songs. I can't digest all of them in one sitting. Definitely going to give it another listen. And yeah, so thank you for actually letting the music speak for itself and not giving us those crazy one-liners before the album.
Man, that would look. Wells over here criticizing Jerry early in the album and stuff like that. And now look at Joel over here.
And then he also said,
I said, yo, you did the same thing. Ye. Nah. You see what happened?
I didn't say Ye was a classic.
Not in the beginning, you did. You guys.
Yeah, but just like I did before I listened to it, I said it. Maybe.
That's off the love.
Maybe.
Right? That was just off the love.
I think y'all be jinxing it, man.
Yeah.
Nah.
Beginning of this album, you definitely said this is gonna be a classic.
Well, I mean, you gotta be excited for the artist that you like. You can't.
There's a difference between being
energy.
Excited and solidifying something guaranteed.
Pat, how many times you do that on RTTV?
All the time.
Yeah,
a lot of times I'm right though.
No,
a lot of times I'm right.
No. Are you?
Yo, if I say it 50 out of 50 times, I gotta get a couple of them bitches right.
Like what,
bro?
I was saying in pure excitement, I'm a big Kanye West fan, and you know. The fact that I was excited and not so at the end is just truth to, you know what I'm saying, to how I feel about the album. So you're going to get the real opinion.
It was funny because he was trying to criticize me.
That
ass. He said, this is the most interesting.
I said, you're doing without a lot, whatever the fuck was. But I said, you're doing a lot.
I'm doing a lot of critique. You critique his critique.
That's what I was like, it's unfair. And I just said that you was doing a lot of it.
I waited until the end. That was for two songs.
You said it was a classic before the shit started.
As a Kanye fan, bro, you gotta chill out, man. You gotta do it a certain way.
Listen.
It's a band, the myth, the maniac.
I was actually just talking at that moment. Like, what the hell? I didn't even hear the album yet. How am I calling it a classic? I was just talking.
Yeah, it's a band, the myth, the maniac, Wilkins_RT. Kanye, you are my favorite artist of all time. I love everything that you've done for the game, but I am also a person that will be honest about my opinion on what I like and what I don't like. So I'm gonna say, like, if I could do it without certain songs and certain verses, I'm keeping a buck. That's it.
Yo, man. Yo. What's good, man? It's your boy DC, man. Yo, this not my favorite Kanye album. I definitely want to go back. I definitely just said Luago.
They kept it to the end, though. They didn't stop.
Bro, you see what I said about Jesus King, and I didn't do that on this one. Like, I like this one better than Jesus King on the first listen, honestly.
Nah.
Yeah, I did. I did.
I'm just 26 songs.
But make sure
the artist make you listen to the same song.
Nah, he did.
He did a Soldier Boy.
And then not only did he make me listen to the same song twice, there's other songs that were very, very similar to other songs.
Yeah.
So it was like, bro, it was like you could have gave me 13 joints, 14 joints.
That's fine.
I understand that he's a smart person and he does it for a certain reason. I'm not going to take that from him. I'm just saying as a listener, that's how I felt listening to the album. Mm. But yo, make sure you go listen to that Kendrick and Baby Keem, though. You know what I'm saying? Family Ties, you shit me. Yo,
I'm going back to Kendrick. Yo,
wait,
Kendrick.
I got a question for you. Yo,
that's the best bet.
Are we going to see the Certified Lover Boy Heart this week, though? Are we going to see that?
Are you going to get it on your head?
Oh, no. Damn, bro. You lying on us?
I'm not going to lie. I thought you was really going to get
it. I thought you was really going to get it.
Yo, bro. We ride our own wave, man.
Oh, it's Certified Faker Boy, yo. It's your boy, DC. You feel me?
Yo, let's not start with you, Kendrick. 5 years later.
Yo, fuck your top five. Fuck that Scott. Burn that hard drive.
Yo, you think he said that to Kanye?
Smoking on your top five tonight.
He heard that Donda, he was like,
he's an idiot.
Yo, man, but honestly, yo, this Friday, stay tuned for the
Pharrell's
Monumental album, Certified Lover Boy.
Yeah, I'm coming. She knows.
And that settles it at
the round table.